summer I was doing my research at the Medical University of South Carolina. And so what we were looking at is the frequency of peroneal tendon subluxation in asymptomatic volunteers. So peroneal tendon subluxation is when the peroneus longus and brevis tendons switch positions within their common shared tendon sheath. This typically produces a pop or a click. But up until this point, no one has been able to determine whether or not this is a pathological condition or part of normal ankle motion. So what we did was we took 25 asymptomatic volunteers, and using ultrasound, we looked at their peroneal tendons. We had them move their foot, reposition in a neutral position, dorsiflexed, plantar flexed, dorsiflexed with eversion, plantar flexed with inversion, as well as circumduct their ankles in both directions. And what we found was in 33% of asymptomatic volunteers, 33% of them had peroneal tendon subluxation. Moreover, we found that subluxation was found during circumduction of the ankles in both directions, but not during static ankle motion. So what we propose is that because this is an isolated entity, we can start to think of this as snapping ankle syndrome, similar to snapping of the hip. And more than that, you can also start to think of this as something that is best visualized using ultrasound imaging because it's found in dynamic ankle motion. So that's our project. Thank you.